It's time to rewind time as we ride Epcot's newest attraction, Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind, not once, but twice on this episode of Attraction Checklist. You're listening to Saturday Morning Media, and now, back to our show. My name is Grant Pachoco, and I invite you to join me on my quest to learn about and experience every Disney park attraction I possibly can. This is Attraction Checklist. Welcome to Attraction Checklist. I am super excited because we are finally bringing you one of the most requested Attraction Checklist episodes of the year, a look at Epcot's new Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind. The guide map describes the attraction saying, "Team up with the Guardians of the Galaxy on an intergalactic race through space and time." Guests must be 42 inches or taller to ride, and the thrill level describes the attraction as being a thrill ride in the dark. Now, before we head off to the Galaxarium, here are five fast facts about Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind. 1. Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind officially opened at Epcot on May 27, 2022. 2. The attraction is built on the site of the former Ellen's Energy Adventure attraction, which we covered on episode 31 of this show. That ride was built in the former Universe of Energy show building, and that show building was reused and retrofitted for Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind, though the bulk of the attraction is housed in a giant blue show building behind the Universe of Energy building. 3. Much like Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout at Disney California Adventure, which we covered in episode 32 of Attraction Checklist, guests riding Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind hear one of six different songs. The possible songs you might hear are September by Earth, Wind & Fire, Disco Inferno by The Tramps, Everybody Wants to Rule the World by Tears for Fears, One Way or Another by Blondie, I Ran So Far Away by A Flock of Seagulls, and Conga by Gloria Estefan. 4. Composer Tyler Bates, who scored the Guardians of the Galaxy films, created more than 2 hours of new music for the attraction, and he even put in a little nod to the original Universe of Energy song. And 5. On June 23rd, 2022, it was announced that Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind would receive a Christmas overlay during the holiday season with a mashup of seasonal songs. Let's go save the planet with Guardians of the Galaxy. Joining me today is John B. DeHaas, and as I mentioned at the top of the show, we are going to go for two rides, and we'll review them both, so stay tuned for that. This is a binaural recording, so if you have headphones, put them on now as we ride Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind at Epcot.
So much more about you, Terrans. We Xandarians and Terrans have much in common, including our mutual love of exploration. Xandarians have explored many celestial bodies, what you Terrans call planets, and many fascinating life forms. In the past, when you witnessed our probes, you referred to our ships as unidentified flying objects, or UFOs. Peter Quill told me that many of you Terrans still believe that these UFOs are flown by
little green dudes with big eyes
and small mouths and antennas and whatnot. In your Terran year of 1977, your scientists launched spacecraft on an exploratory mission. Thank you.
recreational areas for all to enjoy. Our biomes feature rare species of flora from across the galaxy, such as Hynora and Lithars from the Sovereign Planet. One day, we'd love to feature some specimens from your planet, Terra.
Medical biodomes, transportation networks, and more. All designed to provide our citizens with a better way of life.
If you look closely at the Star Blaster's design, you might discover that its wings can flare out and form a star shape, resembling the NovaCore logo.
Thank you. Center, making room for everyone. Thank you. On behalf of all Xandarians, I hope you have enjoyed exploring the wonders of Xandar. As you have seen, your world and ours were born of the same moment, one which you refer to as the Big Bang. As such, we are all galactic neighbors in a vast universe which we and countless others share. For you to travel to Xandar would take 2.5 million years, assuming you had a ship that could fly at the speed of light. So we decided to come to you. But even we could not have reached you so easily were it not for the Cosmic Generator, an advanced piece of Xandarian technology that creates jump points, artificial tunnels that act as shortcuts linking distant points in space. It is our desire to share this wondrous technology with your people so that together we might explore new worlds and create a brighter tomorrow. And now, as the culmination of the wonders of Xandar, you will be teleported to a Nova ship above your planet for a demonstration of the cosmic generator. I trust you will find it an unforgettable experience.
Welcome, people of Epcot. Epcotters. Epcotians. Citizens of Epcot. Does anyone know what they call themselves? What? I'm on? Someone needs to tell me what I'm on. Welcome, Epcot Terrans. I am Centurion Tal Merrick, and we're just about ready to teleport you up to the ship for the demonstration. As you're about to enter a secure Nova area, I must ask you to put away your Terran communication devices at this time. Recording of any type is strictly prohibited. I am very serious about this. Now, please step forward into the chamber. You're gonna love this. Before we begin, I should warn you that we have never teleported Terrans before. But since your molecular structure is very similar to Xandarian's, it should work. It'll work. So long as you are standing inside the lighted ring. You do not want to know what happened last time someone did not stand where I told them to, okay? Stand by for teleportation.
Until we get the cosmic generator back. Piece of cake. Wait!
New king? Where's this king?
The odds are impossible.
Yep.
But it's our only shot. Good luck.
Are you sure you can control it?
Come on, it's me! We got this!
We're all toast!
First there was king, now there is toast. This plan is making me so hungry.
Terrence, listen up. You need to make your way to the evacuation shuttles now. We'll follow the complete if we get our power back. I mean, when we get our power back.
Hello, this planet of the Guardians doesn't stand a chance.
What?
Is the moment?
What did I just say? You need to tell me what I want. Are you Terrence still there? Everything is under control. We're rebooting our subsystem and we'll have the power back soon. We do hope you enjoyed your brief visit with us. Over and out.
nothing to worry about.
Unless we cannot stop this unusually large man, then you're likely doomed.
John, we are at Epcot, and we just walked off of, for the very first time, Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind. Now, as the resident roller coaster expert, what are your thoughts and feelings?
I loved it. I thought it was awesome. I mean, at the first half, I was smiling the whole time going, this is amazing.
Yeah, it's so smooth.
So smooth.
It's crazy smooth.
Yeah, really, really, really well-paced. I mean, I'm not crazy about spinning, but it wasn't horrible. And yeah, it was controlled spinning, so it wasn't bad.
I will say this is the kind of the first time, and it could just be that we rushed over here and I'm on a lack of sleep and I don't have food. Like, I don't feel sick, but I do feel like, a little spinny, a little, lightheaded. But I loved it. I thought it was fantastic. I thought, great song to have as our first song.
Thank goodness.
I've been spoiled on two of the songs, and I'm glad it was a song that I have not been spoiled on.
Yeah,
so,
I love that song.
The only thing, my only critique is, not the ride, but everything leading up to the ride. I did like the reveal of the transporter room.
Right.
I like that, where all of a sudden you're in this big room. That was fun.
Yeah.
but everything looks plasticky, and not that they would really build girders like an iron ship and stuff, but it just, to me, it just was like, I think this could be more detailed.
Oh. And the thing that bugs me is that it's typical Disney ride where something goes wrong and we gotta fix it. It's like, as soon as the power went off, I'm like, okay, here we go. You gotta save the day. I'm like, can you think of a different storyline than it's the same every single time?
Also, you know?
Anyway.
My other thing was Glenn Close, you could see the deadness in her eyes.
Let your eyes follow the teleprompter.
Yeah, she's like, I don't know what I'm saying, but I'm getting paid. But why? It wasn't Bradley Cooper, right? Like, I think it was everybody, but Rockets did not sound like Bradley Cooper.
In the notes, we'll find out in the top five facts, possibly.
Possibly.
Or maybe not, I don't know.
Yeah, here's the other thing. California has that great Rocket animatronic.
Yes.
And they couldn't find a way to work that in here?
Yeah, well, everything, because everything was beamed in. We were on a different planet, so it couldn't actually be here.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. No, that didn't.
But the ride is great. I really like the ride. I like the song choice that we got. Yeah. And should we go ride it again?
Yeah, you want to take a little break?
Oh, it's good. It's one of those rides.
Well, just because we've got another time coming up right now, but unless you want to take a break.
Yes, we did the virtual queue, but then we also paid for Lightning Lane so we could really get the full experience. Yes. But John wants to take a little break. What is your rating schedule for...
I'm going to give it 9.5 Xandars out of 10...
Cosmic generators?
No. What was it called? Hasselhoffs.
Hasselhoffs. Okay, there you go.
It's a deep cut.
It's a deep cut. You got to listen.
You got to know. Go back to the Guardians of the Galaxy Awesome Mix live show and you'll know.
Is this one, like, when virtual queue's gone, you would ride multiple times in a day, or, like, one is good?
One and done. Once a day is good. It's like Space Mountain. I love it, but once, one and done.
All right. Well, we're going to go do it again. Thanks for listening, everybody.
Thanks.
time.
Of course it is about time. Have you not been paying attention?
So just a little bonus, we just got off their second ride of Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind. Still good?
Yes, now I feel dizzy.
You do feel dizzy? I actually feel better this time. Than I like this ride a lot.
I like it a lot. I'm glad we got the song we did the first time. Yeah. I love Tears for Fears, it just doesn't move as well as...
But you know what? It's so smooth when you're riding. The music just like that song too, like... You know, it's kind of airy, that song, yeah. You know, doo-doo. Anyway, I loved it the second time. I don't feel as dizzy this time. And I like this ride. It'll be interesting to see if it's just always slammed after virtual queues, die down or whatever. And actually, I like the lightning lane a little bit better just because you didn't go through all that museum-type stuff. But yeah, I like it. Still like it?
Yes, I felt like I was flying more because there's more stars and stuff. Because we were in the very front this time.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. I forgot to say is on our first ride, we were in the back and we were in the very last car, in the last row. And this one, we were in the very front row. I will say, I think the sound is better in the back seat.
Okay.
Because we were in the back seat the first time.
Yeah.
And the sound was a little bit better. I could hear the dialogue better when we were sitting in the back, then as opposed to in the front seat.
Sure, yes.
But still great.
It's a great ride. So smooth. It's breezy and cold in there, too.
Yeah, it's really great.
Yeah, great ride.
I like this a lot. All right, there you go.
I might have to change my rating.
Uh-oh, you gave it 1 out of 9.
9.5 out of 10, didn't
I? Yeah, something like that.
9.75.
Oh, there you go. Sense. What do you give it on the dizzy scale?
9, hit me with your best shots.
Here's the other great thing, and maybe I will leave it in as an Easter egg as we were getting off the ride. John is wearing a shirt that says John, and this cast member goes, "Have a great day, John." Yeah. It's classic.
Classic. Yeah, right.
All right. Bye, everybody.
Do you agree or disagree with our thoughts on this attraction? Or do you just want to let me know what attraction we should go on next? Send me an email at hello@saturdaymorningmedia.com, or you can let me know on Twitter, where my username is Toasterboy, or connect with the show on Instagram by searching for Attraction Checklist. This episode was masterfully edited by Steven Staver. Attraction Checklist is a production of Saturday Morning Media and made possible by the Saturday Morning Media Patreon patrons who've gone to patreon.com/Saturday Morning Media and set up a monthly pledge for as little as $1 a month. Depending on the pledge level, patrons get new episodes before they are released, downloads of the ride audio recorded for each episode, and exclusive bonus episodes featuring attractions from other theme parks. If you'd like to support this show and the other fun content from Saturday Morning Media, become a patron. Head on over to patreon.com/Saturday Morning Media today and set up your monthly pledge. You can also support the show by telling a fellow Disney fan about it or by leaving us a review wherever you get your podcasts. Thank you so much for listening. This episode of Attraction Checklist is copyright 2022 Saturday Morning Media Grant Pachoco Executive Producer, all rights reserved. www.saturdaymorningmedia.com. You've been listening to Saturday Morning Media. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.